So, it's auction day. So you would have seen part one, went to the viewing day, had a look around, sort of explained how fees and that work, got my catalogue ready. It's now the next day and I've got a few things lined up. I'll try and film inside. I don't know how much I'll be able to get because it's quite busy and things like that. So I'll try and get as much as I can, but I've got a few things jotted down. I'll try and stick them on the screen here. I've got an Office Jet Pro 8610, which looks new in the box, opened box. So that's lot number 88. We'll keep an eye on that. Hopefully that brand new in the box, £150 maybe on eBay. So probably no more than £50-60 maybe pushing it. But remember, we've got add on 20% plus VAT on the 20. So 24% altogether. So yeah, £50, that'll turn into £60-odd. So keep an eye on that one, but that should be a nice pickup if I can get it. We've got lot 89, the very next one. There is a cordless Trackman optical mouse. These go well pre-owned anyway. Again, new in the box, should be a £100 sale on eBay. So hopefully try and bid maximum 40, double money after fees and everything. Hopefully that's a sleeper. Hopefully no one knows what it is. It's just a mouse to them. So yeah, two in a row there, that's handy for me, and early on in the auction. There's a couple of others. We've got like the Rude Bear figures. Looks like a figurine shop went under or something like that. Someone had a collection. They're all brand new in the box. Yeah, just sort of see what they go for. If they go dirt cheap, like £5-10 for a whole box, might as well give it a go. Christmas gifty type things, as we're coming up to Christmas, obviously. There's a couple of other things which are nearer the end, so I don't know if I'll be sticking around. But we've got 284 is a sort of water dispenser like you see in the office. There's two used ones which are full of water, so that's no good, but there's a new one, so I'm going to keep an eye on that one if I am still there. Then right at the very end, I might have to leave a telephone bid or put a bid down and write it down and give it to him. It's 325, it's a box full of HP ink, all brand new. And then 326 next to it, again new ink. I don't know if that's third party or not. Might have to leave a bid, that's right at the end. That'll be like 3 or 4 hours in, I'm not staying that long. And then right at the end, there's an Oculus Rift as well. That's worth like £200-300. So no doubt that'll go for sort of £200-300 at the auction, because lots of gamers go, lots of retro people I know, or I don't know them, I just know they go for retro stuff. Got about an hour till auction time. So I'm gonna have a coffee with the doggies and with the wife before I head off. And like I said, I'll try and film as much as I can in there, but obviously I'm gonna have my mask on, so I might not be able to talk to the camera. If I find a quiet spot, I might try. We'll see what happens. Might come to you at the end of the day or again tomorrow to show what I did get, if anything. Obviously what I spent with the fees and hopefully what I'm gonna get for it online. Actually, before we head off to the auction, like I just said, I might leave a telephone bid or a commission bid. Obviously you can bid in person, which is the traditional way. You stick your hand up and then you there and then can get the best deal or go up if you need to. Telephone bids, you can leave your number, they'll phone you, and then when your lot comes up, you can literally bid on the telephone, but you're not there in person, so you might not get the best deal. If there's something going cheap or if there's a close call, they give it to the person in the room. And a commission bid, you can leave your bid on the viewing day or before the auction with the auctioneer or the assistant. Like say lot 50, I want a bid maximum £50, and then they should work up from that, and that's your maximum. But depends on the auction house, they might go in at bang maximum 50, so they shouldn't do that, but you know, you can't control it, so be aware of that. And then obviously there's online as well. This one isn't online, this is just general auction. You have to be there or telephone or commission, so there's no online, but most auction houses do online bids. That's probably the best way, even though you're not there in person. As long as you've gone to the viewing day, you know what you're bidding on. You can then just waltz around the house or around at work if you work in a unit like me, and then bid online as your unit comes up. Right, let's get there. Auction time. Let's get some bids in.
Among other things in that sale, I have a lot of bankrupt stock, but I have a BMW car, I have a three berth motor cruiser, which, and I will sell it here, and I mean here, at 2 o'clock precisely on the 11th. Right, let's get on with this. I will stop today, by the way, for about 20 minutes, right? Ready, Phil?
Yes, sir.
Right, glassware. Not one.
Glassware.
15, 10, 5, then put them in, anything. Go with jug, bowl, set, 2 large glasses.
Glassware.
10, 5 then. 5 out of it, 6 down, 2 large. Souvenir dog, pouch dog, jewelry cock, etc. 7.
Right, sir.
15, 10, 5 then, put them in. 5, 6 down, 7, you want 7. 8, 9, 9, 10, 9 pounds, 2 and 1, 9. 5 then, put them in. 5 down there, 6 feet, 7 now, you want 7, 8, 9, do you want? 9 of these, 10 now, £9. I'm selling this, £10 of these, 11 now. Lots of pound bears, 29. 5 pound of each, 6 pound anywhere. 6 pound of each, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, £10. I'm selling down here and where, 10, 11 of each, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, £16. HBRB screen room box, 88.
Yeah, sir.
Flat, 20, £10 then, everything. 10, £10 of each, 12 then, 12 o'clock, 14, 16, 18, £20. 18 only in the corner of money, I said, 18 pounds. Any more? £20 a bit, 22, 24, 26, 28.
Ross.
Sorry?
Ross.
Ross.
Yeah, that's it. It's been a while.
Check, trap, looking box, 20 for that, 10, 5 then, put it in. 5 o'clock, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. 16, 17,
18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30 pounds, 32, 34, 36, 38, 39, 40. And I'm out. I won 2 things. Paid a little bit more for the mouse. But yeah, got the printer. Cheaper than I thought, so that was alright. And I've left a couple of bids. Got some cardboard and left a bid on the inks. So I've got to phone them later, see what we got. Hi.
Hi.
Got 2 things out of the end.
Yeah.
Let's go home for some lunch. So back home now, got the kettle on. Won 2 things at the moment and I left 2 bids as well. Load of cardboard, like I said, and all that ink I left a bid on. So we'll phone back in a bit, wait for the auction to end. I left at about 100 or 90, so, and there's 300 odd. So I'll film myself phoning a bit later, might leave it till 3-4 o'clock, see if I did win the other 2, see my total amount, and then show you in depth when I pick it up tomorrow probably, what I did get, why I paid what I did, and hopefully what I'm going to get for it. So now it's tea time. I'll see you a bit later, about 4 o'clock, phone the auction up, see what my total bill is. Cheers. Okay, so a bit later on now, 3 o'clock, auction should have finished, the initial rush should have been out of the way, so let's phone up, see what my total bill is.
Good afternoon.
Hi Joan, it's Mr. Ross, just seeing what my final bill was from today.
Oh, hang on Mr. Ross, I haven't done it yet.
Okay, that's fine.
I don't think you bought any of that stuff that you left.
Okay.
Hang on, I'll just have a look.
Okay, thanks.
No, none of your bids that you left
were
successful.
That's right. So is this the 2 I won on the day then?
No, you just got these 2. You want to know how much they is, do you?
Hey, what's the total bill, please?
81.84.
Okay, thanks for that. I'll be down hopefully later today.
Okay.
Thanks, bye.
Thank you, bye.
Bye. There we go. I didn't win with the 2 bids I put down, and like with the inks, I think I put 30 down, and if I was there in person, I might have gone up a bit more. But there we go. That's the downside to leaving bids. Obviously, if you did want to put a bit more down, then obviously that's just what you put your maximum at. So never mind. Still won 2 things. What'd she say? 81.84, something like that. So the printer and the mouse tracker thing. We'll go pick them up and then see what sort of prices I'm looking at getting. Good stuff. And we're back. So I've picked them up. So we've got two lots in the end, only two. Did leave a couple of bids, like I said, missed out on them. Couldn't stay for the whole thing, so I could have bid on a bit more really, but had to get back. Layla had her 11 plus test, so I wanted to see how she got on with that. Quickly go through the two things I did get, and then what I paid, obviously most importantly, and then what I'm going to hopefully list it for and get on eBay. So there's one after the other. We've got lot 88, which was the brand new HP OfficeJet Pro 8610. Yeah, got this. Here's my receipt. Lot 88, £30. And then I actually paid more for the mouse, which was £36. So like I said, with the commission, so obviously added up, I spent 66, the commission 20%, 13.20, and then the VAT on top of the 13, £2.64. So grand total, £81.84 spent on these two, which seems quite a lot, but obviously at auction, like I said, there's other dealers, people know exactly what it is, so game of chicken till someone stops, but I was lucky to get this at 30, don't know why this didn't go for more. Obviously I said I was happy to pay maybe up to 50, maybe pushing a bit more, but want it for 30, so with fees like £37, £38. Brand new in the box, look at that, it's still bubble wrapped, there's even a toner there it looks like, got the instructions, literally never, looks like it's never been out of the box, or if it's been out of the box it's never been plugged in. And this is a smart printer, I sold one of these for like £100 recently, like used, I don't think it's this exact one, but similar, like when it's wireless, you can scan, like yeah, Wi-Fi, all bells, all whistles. So yeah, £36, £38. I'm going to be listing this between 150 and pushing £200 maybe. So that's a really good one. Still surprised I got it for only £30. Yeah, amazing result. Then from that for 30, brand new in the box, to this one, which I had to pay £36 for. Someone was keen, but I didn't put my hand down. Neither got auction fever, but I had a bid again up to sort of £45.50. I was hoping I'd get this one for, so under budget really. Under target. This is a cordless Trackman optical mouse by Logitech, lot 89, so the very next one. It's brand new opened box, which is really good. Even if you find these out in the wild, like unboxed, pre-owned, these still get sort of £25-30, these trackballs. It's got the red ball on, like funny shaped mouse. But yeah, new old stock, always worth good money. I did open it up. In fact, I'll open it up now and show you. It's got all the paperwork, it's got the CD installation disc. There you go, so there's the box, obviously a few marks from storage. Got the CD there, that installation. We've got the instructions manual, never been opened, which is really good. And then the mouse itself with the, like, the tracker, or the connector, I mean. Yeah, really nice. So, what did I say? Paid £36, so after commission and that, pushing 40-ish. And I'm going to be listing this for about 110, 120. Obviously accept offers, probably take £80-90 after fees, doubling my money. And again, nice small box, no problems there, awesome stuff. So auctions all together, yeah, really good. A lot of faffing about really, so really if I was there in person like I did go, I'd be planning to sort of like go from the start to the finish, buy quite a lot to obviously pay for my time and effort and everything. But when winning just two things, like leave a telephone bid so I can carry on with my day, answer the phone, make bids. Like the commission bids didn't work this time, so I do telephone if I don't want to stay or I'm busy. So with the viewing day there and back, and then being there, I was there for about an hour and a bit, then obviously I had to go back again. It's a lot of to and fro. So yeah, I'd recommend probably if you are planning to go to an auction like that and spend that amount of effort and time, I would stay for the whole day and buy a lot more. Two sort of new items, that one especially, hopefully near £200, really nice. And then a nice bit of retro computing as well. Hopefully another three figure item there. Hope you enjoyed this video. Hopefully it's encouraged you to go to a local auction near you, get some more bargains. Obviously charity shops and boot sales aren't our only source of income, especially now during winter. Again, like the video if you did enjoy it, subscribe if you're not already. I should hopefully be going to this auction more, so I do more similar videos to this. Obviously not explaining every single time, now you know the gist of it. Hopefully throughout the winter I'll be going there, picking up some more bargains. Thanks for watching, I'll see you in the next one, goodbye.